What's up, beautiful people? Everybody doing good? Yo, let me. I got a little testimony I want to start off with today. I was walking with somebody yesterday who came to Blue Jean for the first time recently, and I think the worship band plays like what, 3-4 songs a day. This person said that when they came, it was the first time they'd been in church physically for a long time because of the pandemic. They said that the worship band played their number one song from the retreat that they got saved at, and also their song of the year. And that they cried the entire time in the back pew, and I had no idea. And so, God, we thank you for the way that you set up Sunday services for us. And Holy Spirit, we thank you that you know exactly what each and every person in this room, those listening online, everyone that's coming, Holy Spirit, you know everything about us. And so we thank you that you can tailor a service just to us, Lord. And God, we thank you. I just pray in the name of Jesus Christ that this morning it'll be as if people will walk out of here and say, it's almost as if the band, the worship leaders, the preacher, almost as if everybody had read my diary and my journal, God. Because Holy Spirit, you know everything that everyone has experienced. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that this will be a profound encounter with you this morning, God. I pray that, Lord, that we will have a renewed faith in you, a strengthened faith, an encouraged heart. God, I pray for joy to overflow in the name of Jesus Christ. And God, I thank you that we will, God, go from this place knowing that we have had a direct experience with the living God. Because Jehovah, your name literally means the existing one. And so we thank you that we're not in here talking to walls. We, God, are not in here singing to walls. We're not in here doing that, Lord. But you are here and you have all power in your hands. And so we thank you, Lord, for right now in the name of Jesus, encounter for every single person in this place. And we give you praise. We give you glory, God. I know that according to the calendar, Thanksgiving is once a year. God, Thanksgiving is every day with you. We thank you and we give you praise for bringing us in this place. And God, thank you for this opportunity to just lift our hands, worship you, sing, God, and to rejoice inside. God, we thank you and we praise you in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Come to make you new, this child that you delivered would soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm the sea with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kissed your little baby, then you kissed the face of God. Oh, Mary, did you know? Mary, did you know? The blind will see, the deaf will hear, the dead will rise again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak the praises of the Lamb. Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy was heaven's perfect lamb? This sleeping child you're holding is the great I
I am seeing you are smiling over me. Faith is rising. I am seeing you are smiling over me. Perfect love is fair. bow. We live by God. We give, we can never keep. We gain, we will never lose. Like beauty from ashes, joy from mourning, only you can take a brokenness. Rest is our weapon, joy is our strength. We wait upon the Lord and find the strength to spread our wings to fly. From glory to glory, you tell our story.
Blessings, Jesus.
I just want you. I'm sorry when I'm just going through the motions. I'm sorry when I just sang another song. Take me back to where we start. I open up my heart to you. Cause I'm sorry I have come on my agenda. I'm sorry when I forgot that you're enough. Take me back to where we started. I open up my heart to you. I'm caught up. I just want to sit here at your feet. I'm caught up in this holy moment. I never want to leave. Oh, I'm not here for blessings. It's Jesus, you don't. More than anything that you can do, I just want you. Cause I'm sorry when I've just gone through the motions. I'm sorry when I just sang another song. Take me back to where we start. I open up my heart to you. So I'm caught up in your presence. Cause I just want to sit here at your feet. I'm caught up in this whole. Never want to leave. No, I'm not here for blessings. It's Jesus, you don't owe me anything. More than anything that you can do, I just want. I just want you. Nothing else. Nothing else. Nothing else will do. I just want you. Nothing else. Nothing else. Nothing else will do. I just want. Nothing else, nothing else, nothing else will do. I just want you. Nothing else, nothing else, nothing else. Nothing else will do.
God, we thank you for being with us this morning. Your word declares that where two or three gather in your name, there you are with us. And we feel your presence. We recognize you and acknowledge you. And God, we thank you that when you are in the room, anything can happen. Your word says that all things are possible with God. And so, Lord, we just thank you for being here and thank you for letting us just marinate and bask in your presence and your glory this morning. We thank you that, Lord, as we're in your presence, everything, all anxieties fade away, all burdens fade away, everything that is not of you is taken and stripped from us. And Jesus, we are replaced with peace and joy in your presence. And so we thank you for letting us do it this morning, God. 1 minute or 5 minutes or 1 hour or 1 day in your presence is better than anything we could spend anywhere else. And so we thank you, Jesus. And God, we recognize that we are yours. And so, Lord, thank you for counting us as your chosen people. Each person in this room you chose and consider to be your treasured possession. And so we thank you for that, God. And God, we invite your fire to fall in this place. And we invite for this place to explode in the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you. Amen.
Thanks, Colin. Good morning. Good morning. I am going to try to multitask. Probably not a good idea. Thanks, Colin. Cool. So excited to be here. What a great day. Mary and I are having some of the best days of our lives lately. We've just been really blessed. Moving into a new house and stuff. It's so cool. So cool. Sorry, I didn't plan on saying that, but anyway, thanks for celebrating with us. Like, it's just been amazing. God's love and just his pleasure, and you know, that good stuff is all over us. And a lot going on, but you know, it's all good. We got some announcements I just wanted to go through. And all right, so no Sunday school classes. So of course we'll have church, no Sunday school afterwards. Those are the dates. December 19th, 26th, and January 2nd, we'll get started again on the 9th. And all right. And everybody got all that? All right. And it was also in the email if you missed it. Yes, sir. Good point. Yes, today we do have them, Sunday schools. So thanks, Bo. Right. And Blue Jean Selma Advent Breakfast, that is going to take, yeah, come on, food, woo, so that's going to be awesome, 10:45 a.m., we are going to do that instead of Sunday schools that day, but it'll be a good time together, so next week, all right, Candlelight Christmas Eve service, I'm just reading these with you guys, Anyway, December 24th, 5:30 to 6:30 p.m., come join us as a family to usher in Christmas together. This is such an awesome thing. Bob told me about it last year, and I was like, yeah, I don't know what to expect, but the sweet, you know, presence of the Lord was all over it. It was not just, it wasn't, you know, liturgical or something. It was just so beautiful and really, really worth it. So, yes, definitely come to that. Bring your family if anybody's visiting. Really appropriate for that. You're going to have a great time. Bob knows what he's doing. Let's go to the next one. Isn't that right? Oh, we have a new author in the house, Kate Wood. Congratulations. Comes out on the 14th. So, you know, grab that book. I love devotions. Devotions, daily devotions changed my life 100%. So that's some of what's in this book, and I just highly encourage grabbing a hold of this and doing that all year next year. So anyway, Kate Wood. Awesome. Yeah. Lise Ford. She's not. I wrote a book too. Yeah, more Lord, come on. Great. All right, and then Mary and I have had the most fun, just so much fun coming up with the service and everything today, but this was the highlight for sure, is this video that we're about to play, And it was all the kids at Blue Jean and everything, and they're adorable. This is just for fun. You know, we're not testing them or quizzing them on, you know, what they know about Christmas, but I hope you guys can enjoy the spirit of it and just the joy of it. And I really think it's just something special, and it came out excellent. And so without further ado, you guys ready back there to play that video? Awesome.
Because that's when Jesus was born.
Because it's celebrating when Jesus was born.
To honor Jesus.
For baby Jesus' birthday.
Because Jesus was born.
Because of baby Jesus is born.
It was when Jesus was born.
Because Jesus' birthday.
He was born on Christmas Day.
Because it was Jesus' birth.
Mary.
Mary. Mary.
Mary.
God.
Mary.
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 In a stable.
Bethlehem.
In a manger, in a stable. Because there was no room in it.
Bethlehem.
I didn't.
In a barn.
Barn.
In a stable.
In a stable. I remember that much.
With
a bunch of animals.
Yeah, with a, I don't really remember that much.
Bethlehem.
Bethlehem.
Chapel. Yes!
Shepherds.
Shepherds.
They praise Jesus.
On the shepherds.
The shepherds.
The three wise men,
frankincense, gold,
myrrh.
Wise men.
The wise men.
The three men on camel.
Why? Three wise men.
Wise men.
The three wise men.
Wise men. The wise man.
The wise men.
Joseph.
Father.
God.
Joseph.
God.
Joseph.
Joseph.
Him being born.
Mine is when the three wise men followed the North Star.
When Jesus was born,
when he was a little baby and he got presents.
Probably like them following the star.
Boy.
Say aloud.
Boy.
Say born.
Born. Of him getting born.
When they go door to door, seeing where they could get him born.
Probably when the angels came to the shepherds.
When he was born.
When he was born. Say it, Charlie.
Boy.
When he was born.
Oh. Yeah, you answered that one first.
The part where they went from door to door trying to give birth.
When they were in the stable and they were all the animals were crowded around them.
I'll say 2 feet.
When he was born? When he was born? Maybe 12 inches?
Two foot
when he was born.
When he was born, there you go. That's good. All right, that's
one
it.
Foot.
One foot.
And I'm 4'4".
1 foot. Not that tall. 45 inches.
Okay. That's a great answer.
1 foot slightly tall.
2. 1.
That's fun. Awesome. All right, we're done. Good job.
Action.
Oh, yeah.
Right, smile again.
Smile. There you go. Good job. All right, hey, George, are you excited? Okay.
Good.
No, it's good.
What's that little game up there? What's that little thing up there? Anna.
Who came, do you remember, what is the name of the kid who came and played music for Jesus?
Bongo stick.
Or?
Bongo stick.
Angels.
The angels, that's good.
Angels.
And then there was also one who came and played angels. Like this. Do you, can you tell me
the wise man?
Well, there was like the drummer boy.
The German boy.
Good. You remember the drummer boy song?
No, she said German. And that should be a joke.
Yay! Perfect.
Cool.
All right, we're done.
Awesome. We had so much fun doing that. Y'all, wasn't that good? Ooh, I loved it. I loved their honest answers. When they didn't know something, they would just either shake their head no or just answer something. And honestly, when they said that God was his mother or father, I was like, well, you're right on that too. I mean, spiritually, hey, he is. So let's give a hand to the kids again one more time. Thank you guys for coming, for being a part of that. Y'all did so good. So, and I'll make sure, I'll be sending that video. We'll probably put it in the next email if y'all want to watch it again. And I'll send it to the parents and stuff. So, awesome. All right, well, let's pray real quick. Yeah, Jesus, we just thank you so much. We thank you for sending your son. Now we get to have a time of just remembering that and remembering your goodness towards us. Yeah, Holy Spirit, we just thank you for your presence. Yeah, we love you, Lord. We love you so much. We thank you for your joy, for your kindness. How good you are to us. We love you so much. Amen. Awesome. Yeah, it's been a great week. Like Josh said, we just got our new home. We're so excited. It's just been amazing. We just feel like we've been feeling the goodness of God. It's like, he's like, here you go, Merry Christmas. We kind of had a surprise, little side story, surprise closing. It was kind of like our lender just kept saying, hey, we're not sure when you're going to be able to close. And I thought it was going to be next week. And then he calls me Wednesday. He's like, all right, we're closing tomorrow. I was like, oh my gosh. So now we're shuffling together and trying to get in our new home. So it's really fun. All right, well, I wanted to ask you guys some questions, so I put the kids through asking questions, so I'm going to ask you guys some questions, and I'd love for you to respond. I'll say your response over my mic so that anyone watching online will hear it as well, so y'all get ready. So what do you feel, think, dream, if you can give it in a one word, imagine when you hear the word Christmas? So give me some words, yes. Jesus, okay. Anyone else want to answer? Come on. Oh, I heard family. The day he was born, the day Jesus was born.
Lights.
Lights. Yeah, it can be anything. What do you think of when you hear the word Christmas? The drummer boy, or the German boy, right? The drummer boy. Okay, we got one back here. Celebrate, that's a good one. Awesome. A new beginning, I love that. That's a good one. Anyone else? Okay. I'll go to the... Huh? Joy. Yes. Definitely think of joy. All right. And then what is one of your favorite things to do? If you can give it in one word or, you know, a little phrase. What is a favorite thing, tradition that you like to do at Christmas? Mine would be like baking cookies. Sing. That's a good one. Music. Listening to music. The Christmas. Getting presents and giving. Giving presents. Awesome. Yes. Christmas movie with Queen Latifah. There you go. Love it. Those are so good traditions. Being home for the holidays. Being around family at church. Love that. Anyone else? Decorating the tree. Yes. That is definitely a highlight. That was fun last week. Did anyone who stayed and watched the kids? It was great. They just did so good. We got them all on there. It was awesome. So I love it. All right. And then what is a like song or maybe like a phrase that you think of when you hear the word Christmas, maybe like verse or any song or something like that? So if you want to call those out. Yes. Good. Silent Night. Okay. Yes. Which song is that? I'm trying to remember. Fall on Your Knees. Oh, that's Oh Holy Night. Yes, that's right. That's Oh Holy Night. Good. Yes. Joy to the World. Good. We got one back here. Jingle Bells. Yes. Okay. Mariah Carey. Oh, my goodness. Yes. I love jamming that Mariah Carey playlist. It's awesome. Away in a Manger, yes. Anyone else? Okay, we got George back here. What? Silent Night, he thinks it's silent. Oh, that's so good. Awesome. All right, one more. The Little Drummer Boy, yes. So fun. I remember there was like this claymation video, movie, Christmas movie, I don't know if y'all have seen it, of The Drummer Boy. And I remember watching that as a kid, and it's kind of like, it was good, but it was kind of creepy, too. I don't know if anyone else got that. I'd be like, watch it, and I'd be like, this is kind of cool, but just the claymation was a little creepy. It's like, it's great. It's very artistic, but I don't know if anyone else was like a little terrified of it. I feel like I was. So, all right. Well, when I think of the word Christmas, memories just flood through my mind. I have a picture I wanted to put up. This is me and my family. I'm thinking, I meant to ask my mom this morning how old she thinks I was, but. Oh, it's a little blurry. That's okay. I'm thinking I was probably like 3 or 4 maybe. But I just like think of, you know, family and just getting your matching outfits and getting pictures together and spending time together, making memories, you know, new memories, remembering old memories, reminiscing. And so things that I think of is decorating the house and anything else that would sit still long enough. Being able to sing Christmas carols with, like, friends and family. One of my sisters, she was the HOA kind of manager or whatever you call it, leader in one of her subdivisions. And she would plan every year for us to go sing Christmas carols. And I just feel like, gosh, it's like when you're in the moment, sometimes you think, oh, this is going to happen every year. And it's interesting how some memories, you know, you do something for a certain amount of years and then it kind of passes off, but we still get to keep them because we have them in our memories, which I think is beautiful. And I feel like, you know, I'm so grateful for the Lord giving us that we can remember. Another memory I have is dancing in the Nativity production, the studio I grew up in. They started doing the Nativity when I was 15, and I was actually the first ever Mary that got to play in the production. So it was really awesome to be able to have the honor of doing that. And I just remember thinking, like, wow, like, this is such a crazy role. And it was just so beautiful. We had Mary and Joseph and a little baby doll for baby Jesus, of course. We're not going to dance the real baby. That would have been probably not a good idea. but just so many fun memories of that. We had one kid pee on stage one time, and it's just like, you get to memorize, you know, remember the different things. And the funny thing about that is there'd be a little sheep that would come out. And one of them, I guess, just forgot to say they needed to go to the restroom before getting on stage. So they just decided, like, I'm just going to go here. And right after that, the older dancers had to come out. There was no pause in the music or anything. So they were leaping over it, and it was just hilarious. We were all laughing and just like, okay, great. This is just going to be a fun memory. So there's just so much, you know, that we can think of in past times of Christmas. When I was asking the Lord, so I just asked him, well, what is your favorite part about Christmas? And I heard him say, spending time making memories. So he loves it too. Like, he just loves spending time with us as we spend time with our families. And I just felt like he even remembers, like, I might cry. Like, he remembers being a child and being a part of this world, you know? And I felt like he was just like saying, like, I love those memories of being a part of the earth when I was here. And he loves making the new memories with us. It's just, it was really cool. So, sorry, y'all. Woo. So that's just something that I felt like was on the top of my mind as I was thinking of Christmas and thinking of, wow, Lord, like, you're just so good to us. So I wanted to look back. Let's read together the Christmas story. So this is just the start of it, which is in Luke 1. And we're going to read 26 through 35. I'll give you a second to get there. I was listening to, I don't know if y'all have heard of Bill Johnson, but I was listening to a message this morning that he gave on Christmas, and something that he said that I really loved was he talked about the favor on Mary and how, you know, it was just such a beautiful thing that the Lord favored her and through that just brought the gift of life in her womb. And I just thought that was beautiful. I was like, wow, like his, you know, breath of life, it just, you know, being on her, it was just, I don't know, it was, he explained it way better, if y'all want to, I'm like, I should probably send that out, it was really good, so he's a great speaker, awesome. All right, but let's start reading in Luke, so Luke 1, 26, during the, and I'm reading from the Passion Translation, so just so you know. During the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, the angel Gabriel was sent from God's presence to an unmarried girl named Mary, living in Nazareth, a village in Galilee. She was engaged to a man named Joseph, a true descendant of King David. Gabriel appeared to her and said, "Rejoice, beloved young woman, for the Lord is with you, and you are anointed with great favor." So something that I really loved about this is that it says, "Rejoice, beloved young woman," before she even was pregnant with Jesus. So he said, "Rejoice," and this is before the fact. Mary was deeply troubled over the words of the angel and bewildered over what this may mean for her. But the angel reassured her, saying, "Do not yield to your fear, Mary, for the Lord has found delight in you and has chosen to surprise you with a wonderful gift." I love that too, how it phrases it here, he found delight in you and that he's going to surprise you. Like, that is something that God loves to do. He loves to surprise us. I've seen, like, throughout my life, just moments and times where I'm like, wow, like, Lord, you just really surprised me with that. That was so cool. And he just loves doing that for us. And he loves, you know, it just shows that through even the start of when Jesus came. He surprised Mary with the gift of him. All right, let me find my place. Okay, you will become pregnant with a baby boy, and you are to name him Jesus. He will be supreme and will be known as the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God will enthrone him as king on the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign as king of Israel forever, and his reign will have no limit. Wow. His reign will have no limit. So that, to me, is meaning, you know, he's still reigning today. He is in our lives, and Like, I just love that. His reign will have no limit. Mary said, "But how could this happen? I'm still a virgin." Gabriel answered, "The Spirit of holiness will fall upon you, and Almighty God will spread his shadow of power over you in a cloud of glory." I love that too. Spread his shadow of power. It makes me think of one of the disciples. It talks about his shadow when they would walk by, it would heal people. And I just think that that's so cool that even when Jesus, it says, you know, God will spread his shadow of power over you. So thinking about that and how God's shadow came over Mary in a cloud of glory. I'm wondering, like, you know, what that felt like for her, even if she felt that, you know, is that like, I don't know if you've had moments with the Lord where you just feel like you feel his presence. It's so deep. It's in your stomach. It's in your, I don't know, just you can feel it. And I'm wondering if she felt that. "This is why the child born to you will be holy, and he will be called the Son of God." It's so beautiful. Yeah, so as I read that, just in the past and continue to just think and wonder, like, wow, like Mary had that moment with the angel. And just imagining that time of her, I mean, we don't know what she was doing. She could have been doing chores. She could have been doing whatever. And then all of a sudden, this angel appears. And it's just amazing. It's kind of like, wow, like, that is so awesome to think that, you know, in our daily life, there's no limit to when God can just appear to us and say, "Hey, favored one, I see you," you know? It's like, whoa, like, okay, that's so good. Like, who knows what her relationship with God was like. I know back then women weren't allowed, I think, to study the word. So it's interesting to think, you know, like, what was her time with God? Like, what did that look like? And how did she have that relationship with him? Maybe she had a father who was open with her and let her study at home, or, you know, we don't know, but it's just fun to think about what was it that, you know, drew her to the Lord and drew him to her. And I just, you know, I wonder sometimes, like, wow, that just beautiful favor that he put on her. If you think about it, you know, Jesus was birthed inside of her. And so she was the first one to carry his presence. That's what I feel like. It's like he was in her. So it was almost like, Josh always says it, Mary was the first Christian believer. And I love that. I'm like, wow, that is so true. Like, she was the first one to believe and receive the Spirit, and it became flesh. I just think that's so beautiful. So yeah, we are going to do communion. And as we do communion, I just want you guys to, you know, just sit and think with the Lord and just ask him, what is something that you love about me? That's one of my favorite questions to ask the Lord. And so as we do communion, I know we take communion as a sign of us receiving his forgiveness, but through that we can ask him, so, hey, you forgave me. Like, what is it that you love about me? Why you forgave me? But as they're passing out the communion, I think, is someone going to get it? I think Miss Amy maybe just went back there. Okay, great. Mike's got it. Yay. But as they're passing out, I thought we could sing "Oh, the Blood of Jesus" together. So if you know it, I'm mainly just going to sing probably that first verse. We can sing it together. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood of Jesus. washes white as snow. Let's do it one more time. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood of Jesus. It washes white as snow. So good. It's probably one of my favorite hymns. Thank you. All right, let's go ahead and you can take it as you receive it. And just remembering to ask the question, Jesus, what is something you love about me? Yeah, we thank you, Jesus. We thank you that you came. Yeah, that you said, I'll go. And you came to bring your family back into communion with the Father. We're so grateful. Yeah, and just as we go through this season this year, I just pray that each and every person can experience just a rest with you and time to remember and think on the amazing things that you have done in their lives, the moments they've had with you, and also the excitement and the joy to make new ones, to continue a relationship with Jesus. It's the most beautiful thing. And it's exciting and fun. It's a wild ride. Yeah, so we thank you for your presence. And then it's always with us. We love you, Lord. Amen. Okay, so we have the kids are going to do a little something for us. And also the youth are going to help us out. So McCain and Marin and Jake, can y'all go ahead and come sit on the front row? Just so you're ready for when you need to come up and read. I've given them verses that they're going to read. And then, Josh, you're going to come help me set up for the kiddos. Okay. Awesome. We'll just need to move this also out of the way. Okay. And then once he gets this set up, I'll have the kids come up.